Hello everyone, I am Abhijit Shinde. We will be looking at some doubts of the students which comes in the mind of student when they start with the DSP. Now let's consider what is a signal. Okay. We'll pause over here. I'll give you time to think about or listing out some examples of signals. Okay, now in day-to-day life, when a man or one human communicate with another human, he use some signals. It might be hand gestures, sound, or facial gestures. These signals which are there to communicate in between two human beings cannot be incorporated in engineering systems. In engineering systems, we actually use terms which are signals, for example speed, torque, intensity of light, etc. We also talked about TV signal, radio signal and mobile signal. We are familiar with AM signal, FM signal when we start discussion on communication. Now, interesting thing is that a noise can be also considered as a signal. Here you will see this is a pure sine wave, and this sine wave is an example of a signal. When a noise is added in this signal, it becomes a distorted signal. How to remove noise, we'll see in the further lectures. Now the time signal. When we plot a signal with x-axis representing a time, it is a time signal. A time signal can be an analog signal, which is a continuous signal, or it can be a digital signal, which is a discrete signal. Now, take the example of this. The first one is an analog signal, where amplitude is plotted against the time. Now here the set of amplitude takes infinite values, and therefore it is a continuous signal, whereas in the discrete signal the set of amplitude has very finite number of set. This signal is sampled, that means sample points are taken from this signal at regular interval. A MATLAB is a simulation software which is widely used in DSP. This is the sine wave and the corresponding output of the discrete signal. In a real scenario, a signal cannot be a standalone. It is a combination of different signals. Now here you can see the addition of this four signal is actually this signal. When we sample this signal, we get a discrete values. Now the time interval after which we are taking the sample will be fixed. The sampling, the time can be converted into the frequency. And that frequency is known as sampling frequency. Sampling frequency is can be understood by how frequently we are taking samples from the input signal. We have seen the analog to digital converter, ADC. In the ADC, we have seen the quantization. A step of quantization is a minimum voltage which can be represented by a signal. Now further discussion we will carry out in next sessions. Thank you.